Hi! So today I wanted to share with you some of my all-time favorite makeup items and hopefully give you some inspiration. Maybe you can try out some new things. Disclaimer, as you can see, I'm not that good at makeup. I am still learning. I do check out TikToks and I do subscribe to some makeup YouTubers. And I hope I can continue improving and learning. But I do wear makeup on a regular basis, so hopefully my recommendations can help you out a bit. So I'm gonna start off with the base. And I have very oily skin, which I have been working on. If you want to see my updated skincare routine video, please do subscribe down below. I'll be posting that in the future. But the holy grail that I use on a daily basis is actually this BB cream by Garnier. And this is for combination to oily skin in the shade Light. I'm wearing it right now. As you can see, it's still a bit darker than my actual skin tone, but I feel like in natural light, it's not as obvious and it just gives me a nice matted look. And then upon that, I can build some shininess, some glow, and it's not from my oiliness. So yeah, I definitely recommend it. It's not that expensive. I think I usually get it for around 6 euros, 5 to 6 euros, and it lasts for a very long time. And like I mentioned, my oily skin is quite a problem, especially when wearing makeup. So I have found this Maybelline Fit Me Matte Plus Poreless Pressed Powder. This is in the shade Classic Ivory 120. And I actually just got a new one. I have my old one right here. As you can see, I've hit the pan on this one. It's running out really quick. And I was very surprised. It actually does make my skin look much better. It makes it very matte and it makes my pores look smaller. I don't know how, but somehow it does. And it has a cute little mirror. And then this sponge, which I actually find very useful for applying it. I usually don't use the sponges, but this one is very nice. And it applies a very nice layer. If you have oily skin, I would definitely recommend this to you. And now an item that I actually wear on a daily basis now, even though when the trend started, I wasn't really quite hyped about it, but I love it now, and that's actually a highlighter. This is the Snowflake Loose Highlighter by Anastasia Beverly Hills. And I love this highlighter. It's really, really good. And it gives a nice radiant glow. It just doesn't look too fake, it doesn't look too artificial, so it's very useful for an everyday basis, like casual makeup, and I love this. So now one of my favorite cheap eyebrow products that I use on a regular basis. This is actually from Essence. It is the Make Me Brow Gel Eyebrow Mascara, and it actually has filling fibers inside. If we take a look at the wand, at the gel, you can actually see that there's some like fibers on it, and it just helps to fill in the eyebrows. Do I think there's better eyebrow gels out there? Yes, I'm not gonna lie, but this one, for the price, I think it's very good. And then sticking with the budget-friendly options, it's actually one of my favorite eyeshadow palettes. It's actually by Makeup Revolution London, and this is their eyeshadow palette called Flawless 4. I think their palettes go for around 7 to 12 euros, and I think for the price range, it's amazing quality. Really, I've been using them for a very long time, and I love the eyeshadow quality, I love the pigmentation. I'm gonna give you some swatches. This is what the colors of the eyeshadow palette are, and I love them. There's some warm tones, some cool tones, and I feel like you can play a lot with this one. I also want to get another one from them. I'll put a picture in right here. It was on sale for 7 euros, but sadly I missed out on it. But yeah, hopefully I can get it in the future. I'm just gonna show you some swatches. So these are just the 4 colors I randomly picked. Yes, the black one could be a bit more pigmented, but I feel like for the price range, I think it's amazing. If you feel the actual eyeshadows, they're very smooth, very velvety, and they go onto the skin like perfection. I really love this color. It's definitely one of my favorite ones. I use it with a wet eyeshadow brush, and I love the way it looks on my eyes. And now the item that I actually can't live without. I tried living without this, and I was very sad. I was looking for other options, but I couldn't find any as good as this one, and it's actually a mascara. Yes, I have 3 of them. So basically, this is the Maybelline Lash Sensational Full Fan Effect Mascara, and I can't live with this. Is that sad? I don't know, but I'm very happy I found this mascara. I love it. It gives me amazing eyelashes. It gives me length, it gives me fullness, and I wear it every day. I am obsessed with this. I usually just used the upper part where it curves in. That's what I use for my eyelashes, to just coat them, and maybe then to separate them I use the upper part where it curves out. And I love this. I love the formula. I love everything about this mascara. I've tried some other ones. I've tried Lancome, I've tried Essence, I've tried Max Factor, and they're all good mascaras respectively. I'm not saying that they're bad mascaras at all, but this one works wonders for me, and I just can't seem to find any that would work as well as this one. That being said though, I have been volunteering lately and I have to wear the mask for 8 hours a day, and so the condensation just ruins my mascara, and mascara runs down my face, and I become an actual panda, not just a human. So I had to get a waterproof mascara, and I didn't want to spend too much money. I just wanted to get something cheap that I can use on special occasions, and I actually got this one from Essence. It is the Lash Princess, and I love the packaging. Look at how cute this is. I think it's very cute. And it is the waterproof version, and I've tried it out. I'm not gonna lie, it actually works great on my eyelashes, and it's waterproof, which makes me very happy because I like wearing mascara. I feel like it just adds something to the face. And now, lipsticks! I'm just gonna start off with the controversial one. This is actually the Jeffree Star Velour Liquid Lipsticks in the shade Can't Relate, and I don't really remember when I got this, but I was very excited because I haven't seen Jeffree Star products anywhere else, and then, you know, stuff happened. I don't even know why I chose this color. It really does not suit me well at all. It just does not work with my pigment, my skin tone. I love the way it looks, so that's why I am keeping it, because it's so shiny. I do think that the quality is amazing. I mean, it is 20 euros, so it's not a cheap lipstick, but I feel like the formula is amazing. So if you could help me, if you maybe know some dupes to the Jeffree Star lipstick, please let me know down below, because I do not want to support this brand anymore. So if you have any dupes, please leave them in the comments below. I've heard one of them being the Golden Rose lipsticks. Apparently they can be very good. It was actually suggested by a TikToker. But yeah, I don't know. I don't want to buy more lipsticks, but I just love the formula. So if you know any dupes, let me know down below. I'm gonna put it on so you can see what I'm talking about. I don't know. I don't know why. I feel like this just doesn't fit me. I don't know. Maybe it doesn't fit my skin tone. I don't know. What do you think? But I have a trick. I just take this Rimmel London Oh My Gloss, and wait, magic happens. See, now it doesn't look as bad anymore, so I have no idea. What do you think? You think I could pull it off without the topper? I don't know, let me know. And then we have some more budget-friendly options, of course. I'm all about that. And this is actually Liquid Lipsticks by Essence. This is the Matte About Matte Color Boost, and this one is Stay 8 Hours Matte. I love them. I think Essence makes great lipsticks, also great lip liners, and they're quite inexpensive, and for that price you get quite a good quality. I've been testing out this one lately, and it goes off when I start eating or drinking, so it's not exactly 8 hours, but it'll get you through the day. This is number 4, Matte About You, the Stay 8 Hour Matte version, and the other one is the Color Boost, and it is in the shade 03 Wanna Play. So if you wanna play with some colors, with some lipsticks, I would definitely recommend these ones. Not too expensive, and works great. And the next one we have is actually one that I adore. I've talked about on my channel as well. This is the Color Drama, or I think it's called Color Jolt in America. I'm not sure, but I found it in Germany, and it is by Maybelline, and I love this one. I adore it. It is in the shade 610 Stripped Down, and I love this one. It isn't matte, but I really enjoy wearing it. It doesn't stay for that long, but I wear it more as a lip balm, so just something that makes my lips look a bit nicer and not strictly as like an actual lipstick. But yes, I would definitely recommend this one. I love it. The next lipstick we have is actually by Too Faced. It is the Melted Lipsticks. And this one is the Melted Matte. It is in the shade Queen Bee. I think it's a bit dark for me, but I do still wear it. I really like it. And I really like how it turns matte. And it is quite long wear. So I really enjoy this one. I really love it. And last but not least, this was actually a gift and I love it. It's a bit too shiny for just every day, but if you're going out partying, I would definitely recommend. It's by Sleek Makeup and it's the Shattered Glass. This looks amazing. It's straight up gold and I love the way it sparkles. I mean, look at that. Can you see that? And you have that, you can have that on your lips. It's amazing. I really enjoyed this one. I just have to go somewhere where I can wear it because these days we're just staying inside, but I'm very excited to wear this one. That was just my quick favorites of all time when it comes to makeup. What are some of your favorites of all time? Do you have a mascara like me that you just can't find a dupe for or a substitute for? Let me know down below. I'm very interested to see what you guys have to say. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more of this kind of content or maybe more of my face, please click the subscribe button down below. I appreciate it very much and it helps out the channel greatly. All of my social media links are also down below in case you want to follow me there. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Thank you so much for watching. You are lovely and you're helping me out a lot. I will see you in my next video. Have a wonderful rest of your day, evening, or night. Bye.